Hello everyone, today we're going treasure hunting. Because I've realized that after exploring Skull Cavern to floor 1 million, you pass a lot of treasure floors along the way, especially if your luck is good, and I don't really know what those treasure floors can actually give you. Some people have made some comments saying you can find things like auto grabbers, seed makers, and if that's the case, those are probably actually worth exploring because some of those items are pretty valuable in themselves. So if you ever have the potential to just find them lying around in, say, Skull Cavern, that would be a huge boost to your farm. So much easier to just find stuff than it is to get the skills and materials needed to make those things. So that's simply what we're going to be doing today, is exploring floor by floor, seeing how often we hit treasure floors and what they give us. We're going to be doing this on the good luck day with our special charm in our backpack. That is it, because that's a realistic scenario for most of you to be exploring Skull Cavern in. One day, we might even be brave enough to try for Pam's treasure. But frankly, it's easier to steal a dragon stuff. I have a sneaking suspicion that tomorrow will be the maximum luck, so we're gonna start in Skull Cavern right there. I think I'm gonna bring my tractor along for the ride, because it's gonna make this whole process faster. Oh, apparently we're getting married before we do that, so that's cool. Goodbye, Sebastian. Not sure why you're here. Well, keep the house warm while I'm gone. Now, I've heard different theories on how often you run into treasure floors. Some people say every 20 to 25 floors. I haven't actually confirmed that yet, so it's going to be really interesting to see. I'm going to work down floor by floor, probably even skipping shafts as I go, because I do want to see roughly how often they spawn, because I really don't know anything about these. So basically on floors like this, if I see a ladder right away, I'm going to take that ladder. No sense in mining the whole floors, because it's not really what we're here for. We just need ladders. I could also be spawning these in. I'm not really sure what's going to be fastest at this point, so for right now, just let me enjoy my tractor. And it's always just kind of fun to see what we get as we're mining the floors, considering we're mining every rock available. Plus, on a day with maximum luck, I basically always find a ladder right away. So, spawning a ladder probably wouldn't be that much quicker, considering I'd have to open my backpack and place one, use it, and repeat that process endlessly. Okay, first treasure floor, floor 12. Confirmed. Just gonna see what else we got. We got a second ladder, that's odd, but that's fine. One of it has the potential to drop a shaft, too. Let's clean out our backpack before we open that, because we want to keep our items in order. There's what we found so far. Hopefully you got a good look at that. What do we got? 1-4 quality sprinklers. See, that in itself is a pretty good find, because those would take quite a bit of materials to make and time to smelt them. And there's 4 of them. That's going to water a total of 32 crops. You just plant the crops and forget about them. You know what? I'm going to be an organized human being for once and actually write some of this stuff down. And by write it down, I mean what floor it was I found the first treasure floor on. 12 is also a really easy floor to hit. It would take you no effort to get there anyway. Well, it would take you some effort, but most people will hit floor 12 at least. So on a good luck day, you're probably going to hit 1 treasure floor. The first shaft we encountered is 16 floors down. Like I said, we're not going to take it, because that might skip over the next treasure floor, and I want to see exactly where they are, because I really have no idea how often they spawn. Also, something interesting that someone pointed out in my floor 1 million video is that floors that are all rocks seem to occur on floors that end with 5. So even when I was way down there on floors full of iridium, I wouldn't get the occasional floor with just rocks, and that would be on a floor that ends with 5. So I'm curious to see if that shows up in this video as well. We're going to be able to answer a few questions in this one, hopefully. We'll get some valuable information. There's another shaft, floor 21, and a ladder. First iridium node that I've noticed was floor 22. Another ladder. So if we're staying consistent, the next treasure floor would be about now. 2 shafts, 1 ladder. No treasure floor. So they're not every 12 levels, that's confirmed. This next treasure floor is playing hard to get. The first one was on 12, so that one might have actually been a little bit early. I was kind of guesstimating to be about every 25 levels when I started this video, so maybe we'll stick to that still. Until we pass floor 50, I'm still right. Well, here's floor 50. Obviously, we've only seen 1 treasure floor so far on floor 12, so I was wrong about every 25 floors. It still might be approximately that, but further research is required. Basically, the only thing I've confirmed so far in 62 floors is the treasure floors are a lot rarer than I thought. Now, I just feel like I'm being grossly unlucky, because I'm on floor 72, still only seen the first one on floor 12. It started out as such a promising run. It felt like I was gonna have good luck. Nope. It's probably gonna be 500 floors before I see one again. Just because the game wants to make sure that this video is gonna take forever to make. Well, here's something fun, the floor 100 treasure floor. But because I've already been here, apparently it doesn't give me any treasure. So does this count as the second one? Not really. No, I'm not going to count this one. It got me excited for a second though, because I was like, oh cool, treasure floor. With no treasure on it. Look at all the bats. I didn't even know there could be so many on one floor. That's kind of fun. Watch what happens if I jump onto my tractor with my sword on. Lots of dead bats. 22 iridium, 4 solar essence, 1 battery pack, 1 life elixir. That's more than I've gotten from all the treasure floors combined up until floor 121. Now I'm starting to get curious. Because we're not finding a lot of treasure floors, do you find them more often after shafts? Because I know I definitely have found quite a few after dropping down quite a few floors. Ladders don't seem to be getting me there that often. That would kind of be my next theory to work on. I really have no proof or evidence to support that other than a really rudimentary theory, so we're going to continue on doing the ladders for now, but if we go down to say floor 200 and don't find anymore, we're going to start using shafts. And now the game is just mocking me. There's three shafts on a tiny little floor plus a ladder. Not falling for a game. Not yet. Okay, back to what I was saying earlier, here's a floor full of simply rocks, and it is a floor that's divisible by 5, being 130. So maybe there is something to that. And floor 140? Nothing but rocks. So I'm thinking there is some weight behind that. I'll try and keep that in mind as we're going. Now it's easier to tell because most of the floors should have a redeem on them because we're so deep. So any floor that doesn't is going to stand out to me. I'll be sure to check the floor on those levels. Hopefully we'll get some kind of interesting information out of this whole experience anyways, because so far not a lot's happened. We found one treasure floor and I'm coming up on 150. 145, I can't help but notice it's mostly rocks. There was one small gemstone somewhere in the corner, but no iridium, it's all rocks. So I'm thinking the whole every five floors thing probably has some weight behind it. Okay, we're down to floor 150. I found one treasure floor so far, one. So we're actually going to start using shafts whenever we find them to hopefully see if we find more treasure floors that way. I don't know why we're finding so few of them. Maybe they just really are that rare, but I really feel like historically I would find them a lot more often than this. Oh, also I'm getting tired because I forgot to freeze time. The first shaft. How many floors are we gonna get? Three levels? Why, that's nothing at all. No treasure floor here either. Suspicious. I was gonna say we do have an iridium node on an even five floor, but we don't. That's an iridium monster. Quick look around and it's all rocks, so that's more or less confirmed. Floors that end in multiples of five probably aren't gonna have anything of use on them, so act accordingly. We definitely are getting lots of shafts thanks to the good luck, but no treasure floors. Maybe a good luck days you find more shafts and less treasure floors? I don't really know what to make of it at this point. That's probably not the case, but that'd be my next maybe theory. The next problem I'm going to have with this now is that I wanted to compare some of the treasure floors. I figured I'd hit probably 4 by floor 100. Then do the next 100 levels give you better loot? What about the next 100 after that? That would have been really easy to determine, because normally people can't really naturally get down lower than, say, floor 400. So the loot would change very quickly over those 400. Then if you went down to floor 1000, you should find insane loot because no one would really ever be able to make it there anyway. But nope, I'm going to be hitting floor 1000 and still looking for my second treasure floor. I just took a shaft to get to floor 204. That was two or three shafts in a row right there. That probably also confirms that you're not more likely to find treasure floors out of shafts than you are for ladders. It's not an even comparison yet, but being that I'm not finding treasure floors anywhere, it doesn't seem to make a significant difference one or another whether it's a shaft or a ladder getting you to the next floor. Treasure floors just don't exist anymore. 215 floors later, I found precisely one treasure floor. So I rage quit. But here we are, back again. I'm actually just gonna simply skip it to tomorrow to hopefully get more treasure floors along the way. At least this way we'll get a day-by-day comparison to see how much it can vary. It may not make a lot of sense, but it's kind of the option we're left with. I'm blaming it all on Sebastian, and it is winter now too. It's the same thing today, maximum luck with a special charm. Hopefully we find a treasure floor with some consistency. So exactly the same thing as the day before, but this time my tractor has a slightly bigger radius as well, so hopefully it'll break rocks even quicker. Again, I'm going to be avoiding shafts as I go. I want to go floor by floor so as not to potentially skip over a treasure floor. I'm going to try and go down at least as many floors as I did before, 215, hopefully finding more along the way to give us some kind of results. If I don't, that would indicate the treasure floors are just really, really rare. Wow, look what actually happened. Floor 30, a treasure floor. It's been ages since I've seen one of these. Floor 30, I got to make a note of that as soon as I throw out all the garbage I found along the way. Well, not garbage, but unless it's a treasure chest, it's garbage to me. Pumpkin soup. 5 of them. Interesting. I can't really remember what pumpkin soup do. 200 energy, 80 health, 2 luck, and 2 defense. These are awesome. These wouldn't be too bad to make as long as you have the ingredients prepared ahead of time. Obviously it's hard because it might be a multi-season crop ingredients, but 2 luck is huge. If you can get 2 luck anything, that boosts your luck way more than the game naturally can by quite a bit. It's a real living, breathing miracle. A second treasure floor. On the same day? It can happen. Floor 97. Now, what do we got? Cactus seeds! Probably not worth it, being that you just buy these from Sandy in the desert, and you have to cross a desert to get to this place. And they're not very expensive, but hey, that's something. And that would also seem to confirm that the treasure floors are random. They don't appear on any set number of floors or anything like that, because this one's on 97. That is a prime number. When I noticed that yesterday's treasure floor was on floor 12, and today's first one is floor 30, I thought maybe they could appear on multiples of 6. But floor 97? Nope, so they're completely random, and apparently pretty rare. Again, floor 100 had me excited for a sec, and then broke my heart. Check out this treasure floor. Floor 122, so this one was actually not too far away from the other one. We got one giant slime for boxy things, one shaft, one ladder, plus a treasure chest. There's all sorts of fun stuff on this one. Let's see what we get out of these, if anything. Cave carrots, boring. Sap, even more boring. A battery pack, which is actually quite a good find. And an omni geode, which we found a billion of already. But the real question is, what's in this guy? One prismatic shard. Now, is a prismatic shard considered good treasure? I'd be kind of disappointed if I got one on floor 122 of the mines. You probably found a few others along the way anyway, so finding one more doesn't really add a lot, other than a little bit of value. I would way rather find some iridium sprinklers or something at that point. This must be like the luckiest day ever, floor 150, and we have yet another treasure floor. Is it my birthday? Hard to say, another prismatic shard. That's really disappointing. But at least we're finding treasure floors. That's the fourth one we found just today. Yesterday we went considerably further, and had only found one so far. I was starting to give up hope. So we'll keep going and hopefully find some better treasure than that. And we have another one right away, floor 154. Only had to go down another 4 levels, so that shows they can show up fairly frequently. Let's clear out the rest of the stuff, even found an extra ladder. Please be something good. A red cowboy hat that you can't even see. Is that considered treasure? Not personally, to me it's not, but hey, it looks good. I'm not actually super familiar with the clothing in this game. Can someone confirm to me if this is the only place you can find the red cowboy hat? If so, I'm gonna wear it forever. It does actually look pretty unique though. I've never worn this. I don't think I've ever found this before. So I'm gonna consider that pretty decent treasure, especially if it's unique to this area. Another one, floor 182. 182. So they're actually getting a lot more common. For whatever reason, they're miles more common than they were yesterday. The Slammer. That's actually pretty good considering the damage it does. 40 to 55. I just like the name, the Slammer. Kind of fun to say, rolls off the tongue. Okay, give me this. What do we got? Another prismatic shard. How boring. What was this, our third one already? If I had a choice between a red cowboy hat and a prismatic shard, I would take the red cowboy hat. And I don't even like clothing. Well, we've officially made it as far as we did yesterday, floor 215. So at this point, I'm going to say that the treasure floor spawning is absolutely random. There doesn't seem to be any rhyme or reason to it. And its most common gift seems to be a prismatic shard, because we found 3 or 4 of those already, and a few other small items. Oh, but here we go again. Floor 224, we have another one. Let's break up everything else real quick. Get that out of the way. Yeah, whatever. You know what? Let's just break open the chest. Enough waiting. And eggplant seeds. 10 eggplant seeds. Kind of an odd gift. Eggplant seeds are quite cheap normally. They're a fall crop. But hey, that's kind of fun to find, as long as it's not the generic stuff. I'm okay with that. Probably the worst thing I've found so far, honestly, because they're really cheap seeds and only 5 of them. 10 of them. But hey, that's why I waste my time with these things, so that you guys don't have to. Super lucky all of a sudden. Floor 247, we got us another one. Guess what we found? You got it right, a prismatic shard. The most boring gift ever. And how many of these have I found now? 16, and I threw away a stack not that long ago, so we found probably about 25 of those so far. I don't think I'm gonna go much further than floor 300. I think I've got a big enough sample size to see. I was kind of hoping to find more treasure floors along the way. Like I said when I started, I thought there would be about every 25 floors by my guesstimation. I was wrong. You know what we're gonna do? We're gonna go to floor 315, 100 lower than it was yesterday. I've already found a ton more treasure floors, so it's not really gonna be a big deal. I just wanna end it right here. We'll go one more since we found a ladder already. All right, that's it. Going home. So thinking about this, it's absolutely random how often the treasure floors show up. Both days were the same luck, but the first day I found one treasure floor on 215 floors. The second day, I had found 5 by then, and another 2 in the following 100 floors. So it's completely random how many you find. I really don't think the luck of the day is going to be a factor for this, being that I tried both days with the very best luck and had such a wide variety. If I could potentially hit one treasure floor on the best of luck in 215 floors, I wouldn't even imagine what a bad luck day would be, so I don't think luck's a factor. Also, the treasure itself varies wildly. The pumpkin soup is probably actually the best thing I found. That's actually really good. Because compared to some of the other things I found, like the seeds in particular, well, these are just miles better, because you can just buy these cheaply from the store at any old time, any time of the year really, not a big deal. Obviously these have to be in season. But the pumpkin soup, you have to grow pumpkins, and then get the recipe for it, and then get the other ingredients for it, and then make it. If every treasure was as good as pumpkin soup, I'd be a lot more inclined to go exploring. And of course there's the prismatic shards, boring as ever, I found 45 of those down there. You get down deep, you'll find nothing but prismatic shards. Red cowboy hat? Pretty neat. And let's just go ahead and throw everything in there just for fun to see what it's worth, because hey, why not? Definitely no rhyme or reason to how often I hit those floors. I found it on 30, 97, 122, 150, 187, 224, 247. And then yesterday I found it on 12. That was it. 353,000 gold for the day. You want to see it? It's probably mostly prismatic shards and iridium. And indeed it is. Now, if only I had a mod that would spawn only treasure floors somehow. Mod maker, are you listening? So in conclusion, the treasure overall mostly sucks, mostly prismatic shards. Luck shouldn't have a factor if you're going looking for treasure, go on any old day. And floors that are multiples of 5 seem to have only rocks. Hope you liked it. Thanks for watching.